have never before seen photos today of one of Saturn's moons and why it matters. Now beaming back to Earth. Check it out now. It is the best look yet at a tiger stripe, a crack in the surface of Saturn's moon, spewing water vapors, creating huge plumes of ice. And you wonder, why does that matter?
Deep within the realm of gas giants resides a mysterious world, veiled in a thick haze. It's Titan, a moon larger than Mercury, orbiting the magnificent Saturn. Titan has fascinated scientists for ages. Beneath its cloudy cover, vast seas, lakes, and rivers flow across its frozen surface. It's the only place in our solar system, apart from Earth, where liquid moves freely. Could Titan's watery landscapes hold the secrets of life? And if so, what kind of life forms might thrive there? Let's find out.
Saturn has a moon, one of the largest moons in the solar system, called Titan. Titan has an atmosphere, the moon with an atmosphere. That's cool. It's got an atmosphere, it's very cold. So water is completely frozen solid. I mean, we call it ice, but on that moon's surface, it's the bedrock.
Titan, Saturn's intriguing moon, continues to baffle scientists despite four spacecraft missions that have flown by it. This mysterious world raises a multitude of questions. Where did its dense atmosphere originate? How did its remarkable lakes and seas come into existence? And perhaps most importantly, could it be a habitat capable of supporting life? These mysteries surrounding Titan fuel the curiosity of scientists, driving them to seek answers and unravel the secrets hidden within this enigmatic moon. The first look of Titan's liquid landscapes surfaced during the early 1980s, when the Voyager missions passed by this moon. At that time, faint suspicions arose, hinting at the existence of expansive bodies of liquid within its boundaries. However, it was not until the arrival of the Cassini spacecraft in 2006 that these suspicions were clearly confirmed. The revelations were astonishing. Titan's lakes and seas, unlike Earth's vast oceans, were not composed of water, but rather an intriguing blend of liquid methane and ethane. The evidence for these hydrocarbon-rich reservoirs materialized in dramatic radar images, depicting sprawling lakes and seas predominantly adorning the polar regions of Titan. Some of these hydrocarbon bodies rival the sheer magnitude of North America's renowned Great Lakes.
There were liquid lakes of methane. Methane is that gas that comes out of your stove. On Titan, the methane has liquefied the rivers of methane, lakes of methane. Who is to say that there isn't life based on liquid methane there? Just as here we are life based on the liquids available to us, water. So maybe life doesn't require liquid water. Maybe just life needs liquid anything.
Mechanisms responsible for the formation of Titan's lakes and seas are still unclear. The prevailing hypothesis explains that methane and nitrogen present in the moon's atmosphere undergo a complex breakdown process, eventually condensing into clouds and subsequently precipitating as rain or snowfall. This intriguing cycle, distinct from Earth's hydrological cycle, unveils the moon's remarkable ability to sustain liquid reservoirs amidst its otherwise frozen terrain. However, the potential presence of liquid on Titan raises a profound question. Could it signify the existence of life? On our home planet, the maintenance of atmospheric methane predominantly relies on the metabolic activities of various organisms. For instance, simple biological sources like peat bogs, rice fields, and the digestive processes of animals such as cows and sheep contribute to the continual refreshment of methane in Earth's atmosphere. Titan's methane-rich environment sparks speculation that it might foster life forms with an entirely different biochemistry from what we know.
Well, realize that by rights, Enceladus, this moon of Saturn, should be frozen over. I mean, we are a billion miles away from the sun when you look at these photographs. By rights, it should be frozen, but there we have a new energy source melting the ice, pushing perhaps 100 geysers into space.
Nevertheless, life on Titan would be unlike anything we have encountered on Earth. The absence of liquid water and the extreme cold prevailing on this moon pose significant challenges to conventional organisms. With temperatures hovering around a bone-chilling minus 179 degrees Celsius, or minus 290 degrees Fahrenheit, Titan's environment stands as a harsh and inhospitable realm. Despite these daunting conditions, the resilience and adaptability of life cannot be discounted. Interestingly, on our own planet, some microorganisms have exhibited an exceptional ability to survive in hydrocarbon-rich environments. These hydrocarbon-tolerant organisms thrive in conditions similar to the lakes and seas found on Titan. The existence of such life forms offers tantalizing possibilities for the potential presence of life within the moon's ethereal liquid landscapes. Should life indeed manifest on Titan, it would necessitate adaptations to its unique conditions, leading scientists to speculate about the likelihood of a radically different biochemistry, potentially relying on hydrocarbons like methane and ethane as fundamental components. The extraordinary dissimilarity between Titan's environment and Earth's biosphere underscores the formidable challenges faced by organisms attempting to colonize this moon. The very structure of life on Earth, with its lipid-based membranes serving as protective barriers, would be untenable in the absence of water and under the frigid temperatures of Titan. However, alternative models, such as acrylonitrile, hold promise for potentially fulfilling similar functions in Titan's extreme conditions.
Is there life there?
Possibly.
If there's water.
Yeah, think of a racquetball or a tennis ball. As it tumbles around Saturn, it rotates and it's squeezed by gravity. That causes friction, as you pointed out. That causes heat, which melts the ice, meaning that some of these moons actually have liquid oceans underneath the ice cover. Not just geysers, but oceans. And that's why James Cameron put Avatar on Pandora, a moon of a Saturn-like planet.
Scientists have made an astonishing discovery on Titan. They have found direct evidence of acrylonitrile molecules, and there seems to be enough of them to potentially support millions of single-celled life forms. This revelation opens up a realm of possibilities, suggesting that microorganisms might form the foundation of a complex ecosystem on this unusual celestial body. It is conceivable that larger organisms could even feed on these microscopic life forms, creating a delicate balance akin to the food chains we observe on Earth. However, amidst the excitement, it is essential to acknowledge that our understanding of life on Titan remains limited. The Huygens probe, the lone visitor to touch down on Titan's surface, captured breathtaking images as it descended through the moon's hazy atmosphere. The images revealed a seemingly desolate expanse, a dried-up plain adorned with scattered pebbles, possibly remnants of a time when liquid methane flowed freely. Regrettably, there were no apparent signs of life in this barren landscape. While the prospect of extraordinary life forms thriving on Titan is captivating, there are alternative explanations for the presence of methane in its atmosphere. It is more likely a result of geological processes rather than the activity of living organisms. Titan's formation involved sequestering volatile compounds like methane and nitrogen deep within its interior due to the moon's intense heat. Over time, as the moon's interior cooled, these volatile compounds escaped through fractures in its icy crust, amalgamating to form the complex mixture of gases that constitute Titan's thick and mysterious atmosphere. So, does the prevalence of methane in Titan's atmosphere imply sterility, making this intriguing moon devoid of life? Not necessarily. Intriguing observations from the Cassini spacecraft and the Huygens probe hint at the possibility of a hidden subsurface ocean lurking beneath Titan's icy facade. This tantalizing revelation has ignited the imagination of scientists and sparked the hope of discovering extraterrestrial life. Water, the elixir of existence, has long been regarded as a fundamental ingredient for life as we understand it. And if this hidden ocean does exist on Titan, it could serve as a nurturing abode for organisms adapted to the extraordinary conditions of this enigmatic moon. However, the subsurface ocean of Titan would present a strikingly different environment compared to Earth's familiar waters. Its frigid temperatures would plunge far below the freezing point, while the presence of dissolved salts and other substances could dramatically affect the ability of any potential life forms to survive. The chemical makeup and unique challenges of this subsurface ocean create an ecosystem that demands innovative exploration and understanding. Also, Titan's unique chemistry and rich organic compounds make it an ideal laboratory for studying prebiotic chemistry, the chemical processes that might have led to the origin of life. Scientists speculate that the complex organic molecules found on Titan could provide valuable insights into the early stages of life's formation. In fact, this moon's surface is believed to be geologically active, with cryovolcanoes erupting icy materials instead of molten rock. These cryovolcanoes could release a mixture of water, ammonia, and methane into the moon's atmosphere, potentially contributing to its intricate chemistry and creating dynamic environments for the development of life. Some scientists propose that beneath Titan's icy crust, there could be hydrothermal activity, hot springs fueled by geothermal heat. These subsurface oases might offer a sanctuary for life, providing warmth, energy, and the necessary chemical ingredients for organisms to thrive. The dense atmosphere and low gravity of this moon could enable the existence of airborne life forms. Hypothetical organisms, such as balloon-like creatures, or microscopic particles could navigate the skies, extracting energy from sunlight or chemical reactions, and harnessing the complex atmospheric chemistry to sustain themselves. Scientists believe that Titan's atmospheric conditions, including ultraviolet radiation and the interaction between solar particles and its atmosphere, may lead to the formation of intricate, self-assembling organic structures. These structures could potentially serve as the building blocks for life, similar to the role played by DNA and proteins on Earth. In our pursuit of knowledge and the search for life beyond Earth, Titan holds a prominent place. While concrete evidence of life on Titan remains elusive, the complex chemistry and bewildering landscapes of this moon continue to captivate scientists and explorers alike. The Dragonfly mission, slated for launch in 2027, embodies our relentless curiosity. This ambitious endeavor will dispatch a rotorcraft lander, similar to the successful Ingenuity craft on Mars, to traverse Titan's surface. Dragonfly's multifaceted exploration will encompass diverse locations, such as dunes, craters, and the equatorial region, where it will meticulously investigate the potential for liquid water and the chemical conditions conducive to supporting life. As the mysteries of Titan beckon, the quest for understanding expands our horizons. The allure of this distant world with its methane lakes, shrouded atmosphere, and concealed subsurface ocean promises to revolutionize our perception of the cosmos. With every mission, every flight, and every scientific endeavor, we venture closer to unlocking the secrets held within this celestial enigma. Could Titan hold the key to discovering extraterrestrial life, reminding us that we are not alone in the vast universe? Share your views and comments, like, subscribe, and watch more content like this here.